Kevin, you're here to scout for the Lakers, the Louisville players. Tell me who you're looking at and what do you see in those guys?
Well, first of all, you know, anytime you scout, you look at a player, you want to see what kind of program he comes from. And you look at Rick's players. Rick has always had, wherever he's been, has had athletic players who play hard and fast, who like to shoot the three, and who play great defense. So if you can be taught to play the right way, you have a good chance to play the next level. So, Rick, even though I'm really not at liberty to start naming players and talk about all their skill sets, I think your viewers know who the best player is at Louisville. He's a big guy who's about 6'8", 6'9".
Yeah, maybe his name is Montrez. Yeah. See, how much can you tell us about his game and what you think of him?
Well, it'll certainly translate to the NBA. The one skill set that does is rebounding. And, you know, when you're a high flyer, play above the rim, you're immediately going to catch the attention of the NBA scouts and the NBA people. But what you like about is the program, as I said, and you want to see a well-rounded player who is a good teammate, who is a kid that, you know, understands it's going to take him some time and be able to learn and keep contributing to a team, but you got to keep getting better. And we've seen him get better over his career and since he's been in Louisville, and why not? He's only going to get as good a coaching, as good of player development and weightlifting and all those kind of things to make him a great player someday.
Well, Coach Pitino always talks about his motor. Is that something that impresses the scouts?
Oh, of course it does. You know, the obvious things that, you know, the fans can see is the talent level, the lane, the dunks and stuff like that. I'm looking at intangibles. I'm looking at how's he handled himself in the on the bench with the coaches. Is he the first one out here working out before a game? And Coach Pitino's been great to allow us to go to practices. I like to watch players practice. I like to see if he plays with that same kind of intensity that he shows in a game. Because you can't just dial it up and on in an 82-game schedule in the NBA. You got to bring it every night against the world's best.
U of L's had some ups and downs. Can you see them making a run come late in the tournament?
Rick's teams always seem to get better, don't they? You know, so just when you think maybe they're struggling a little bit, they turn it up a gear. But that ACC is a monster. You know, it's a really tough conference, and the competition level that you have to go into every night, I think that they'll be there certainly. NCAA is what everybody wants to shoot for, and it's a great conference. I think if you finish in the top 7, 8, 9 in that conference, you're going to get in.